Brown, Sam Gardner, Amethyst. We are drone one, the submersible drone. So when we... when we contact our customer, he gave us some ideas of what he wanted the submersible drone to accomplish. The first thing we got, obviously, is that it's got a fully waterproof design that's capable of interacting with the water, moving through it, and into it. We're hoping to get a 10-minute flight time from the drone, including air time and water. We were hoping it would reach a depth of about 3 meters.
Excuse us, we would like to know which presentation we were watching.
I'm sorry, this is drone
drone one.
Can I just overwrite one of the other files?
Yeah, that's what I just go ahead and put in whichever column. Do we have two drones? It doesn't matter. Just put it in whichever column.
So, no, well, wait a minute now. Let's have them.
Go tomorrow.
No.
We don't have time. Just put it wherever you can.
I'm going to call drone leveling.
What was your name before you called yourself?
Just drone.
So the first drone column, we'll call it drone one and move along.
Overwrite the column called plant water.
Well, there is mouth guard.
That's not a mouth guard?
Yeah. Just before the water.
Go ahead and overwrite plant water.
Oh, okay.
Suggestion is to overwrite plant watering. We'll make a new call for them on Friday.
Okay. Okay. Project number 17.
Got it. Sorry.
All right. Yes. Go
ahead. All right. All right. For the sake of time, I'll just continue right where I left off. So we needed to go. We wanted to go about 3 meters underwater. We needed to be reusable, so it's not just a one-time deal. It needs to be able to come back out of the water and into the air, and needs to take off.
Okay, so after talking to our faculty that served as our primary users, we came up with this best scenarios and different concepts that would adapt to different needs. So the best case scenario was that the drone was able to land on the water, to submerge in water, to get out of the water. The second best scenario was that it would serve as a boat, so it would land on the water and it would be able to go through it and then take off. And the least ideal scenario was that it would just be able to land on the water and get out of it. So all of them needed to be waterproof design, and all of them like adapted to most of the primary user needs.
So the top right was our selected concept.
Yeah, so now that after we selected the concept, we came up with our final prototype that used basically a ballast system that would be able to fill it with water sea tanks so that it would be able to sink. And we made an entire body so that it would be waterproof using PVC piping and junction boxes made out of plastic.
So here we demonstrate the all-up weight flying and hovering and landing safely. So these are ballast systems, so they have pumps that pump water in and out. We showed it this way because we had to do our final test at night, and it was kind of difficult to see how the ballast system actually works, so we thought we'd show these separately, so you can see it fills with water and then it evacuates the water to raise back up to the surface. So for future work, we'd like to improve our body design by using form-fitting parts or carbon fiber to reduce the weight. So our biggest issue was getting motors and batteries powerful enough to get the weight up. Same again with the battery. The motors are more efficient. We can increase the flight time with a better battery. To create a compressed air system to eliminate the need for a snorkel, because we have to have these tubes to allow air back into our ballast tanks. Reduce the weight for the ballast system, and the biggest one is improve our buoyancy balance, because as you'll see shortly after this, once it was fully submerged, the drone had a tendency to flip over once it was all the way underwater. So we didn't have a solution for that because we needed to add weight to the ballast system to keep it level, but then it would not take off from the water anymore. So we'd need to improve our ballast balancing in the future. And special thanks to Ethan for helping us a lot with the electronics and doing our circuitry and things like that. That's all.
So, questions from the judges?
So your main design constraints were different depending on which scenario you chose, is that right?
Right, so we had customer needs, and we evaluated those, and we came up with four separate designs and chose the one that met the customer needs best. And our final design hit the most of the criteria.
I've seen the Georgia Tech one that sinks to the bottom of the pool and actually flies up from above. River rotors work in water.
Okay, so you guys sunk and were able to break off the surface, or not yet?
No, once we got to the bottom, once we tried to reverse the buoyancy, it flipped upside down because the air filled up in the ballast tanks, and it flipped it over.
Static stability.
Yeah, well, that wasn't something we accounted for in our analysis, so...
Okay.
We weren't able to take off from the water.
Okay. All right, thank you very much, guys.